I'm making Yuri in modeling clay.
Come on, everybody, let's all play a little game. If you've been here since the beginning,
you have to constantly hydrate this type of clay, so I left out a bowl of water to use.
And you sharpen up your blade, then you spread apart your fingers, and this is what you say. I love to play the knife game. I love to stab my hands. Some people think I'm crazy.
Based on my previous experience with this clay, you cannot use chunks of aluminum foil or thick wires in it because when it dries, it shrinks and also cracks, especially when baking it.
Say a prayer to the Lord of Knives, cause this is how we live our lives. So grab your knife and chop, chop, chop. Risk your life and chop, chop, chop. Take a shot and chop, chop, chop. I know I will never stop. Stab the blade and chop, chop, chop. Play the game and chop, chop, chop. Blood and pain and chop, chop, chop. We're all insane, so chop, chop, chop. Some people use a pencil. Some people use a pen. Some people use their finger so they don't hurt their hand. But everybody knows the only way to play is to use a sharpened knife when doing five-finger fillet. So grab your knife and chop, chop, chop. Risk your life and chop, chop, chop. Take a shot and chop, chop, chop.
I also baked this figure just for the sake of speed. Even when the clay isn't dry yet, the clay can still kind of break apart, which is why it's important to keep it hydrated. Even though it cracks easily, it can also be fixed easily too. using a blade to make another blade. What I've noticed with this type of clay is that the hair can break off pretty easily, so to reinforce it, I'm using polyurethane, which I typically don't do, but this is an experiment, so I want to see how it turns out. I used acrylic paint for the hair and skin.
I challenge you to a battle of knives.
Knife fight, you're gonna fight for your life.
Knife fight,
you're gonna fight with a knife.
I use oil color for the bow and watercolor for the jacket. The watercolor absorbed into the jacket, so it was fine, but part of the jacket got the polyurethane on it, so it didn't absorb on that part too well, so I had to wait for that to air dry before adding a second coat. Same thing with the bow because some polyurethane got on there too. As I suspected, the stand was unbalanced, so I added a second knife and then glued it to the first one. I also had a hairdryer nearby to help speed up the paint drying process. There was so much polyurethane on the bow that I tried the oil color again with the skirt, and the part that could absorb into the skirt worked out just fine.
I'm gonna slice you up.
I'm gonna cut you down.
I'll put you in your place.
I'll put you underground.
This is the end for you, you gutter crawling cur.
I've got a tip for you, get the point?
Yeah, sure.
It's time to face the music.
Time to face the facts.
Time to fight the bullet.
Time to pay the tax.
I have a brand new Etsy store. And I have an eBay account, so I might end up selling these because, like I said, these are just for experiment purposes. If I do, I'll try to fix Natsuki's figure first, and then I'll go ahead and leave a link in the description as to where these can be bought if I do choose to sell them. So please leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.